definitely can't wait to see the Sims on the potential Night Fae legendary.
What's up?
Mic was wide open.
What?
Your mic that whole time had been wide open.
Oh, my bad. It wasn't showing up in my Discord. And I pushed the talk on, so that's weird. I was like...
Huh. Probably kind of how Atterbury's mic is stuck open.
Not right now. Not on my head.
Good.
You're good right now.
Nope, no, it's good.
I mean, Discord's been going downhill since Microsoft bought it.
So I don't think it's confirmed.
It hasn't been confirmed yet?
I think it was just rumors. Yeah, there's just a bunch of news reports, but it's just a lot of like rumors about Microsoft wanting to buy Discord, but there's no actual like legitimate source that says Microsoft is looking to buy Discord for however many.
I don't think Discord is looking to sell.
Yeah, I mean, it makes zero sense.
Invested in Teams. The Discord people who started the rumors, just they're gonna do like an IPO, trying to drum up interest in it beforehand.
I was thinking that. Nah, they would. If Microsoft bought Discord, it wouldn't be to use for like an office product. It'd be like for Xbox or something like that.
I mean, isn't that what Xbox Live is?
Yeah, they'd probably tie it in.
I think you can already use Discord on PSN and Xbox.
Got a gig for ya. Not to my knowledge, you can't.
I know you can use it on PlayStation, but I cannot confirm about the Xbox.
Pretty confident you can on Xbox. I've never seen that.
You cannot on Xbox.
Pretty sure I don't care about Xbox because I am PC Master Race.
Same.
Xbox, not PC.
No, it's an Xbox.
Console. I mean, console.
I mean, I understand, but also, like...
I mean, shit, consoles probably have better GPUs than I have right now. Fuck.
Maybe that's where all the good GPUs are going.
Honestly, Xbox. My Xbox is just my television at this point.
Yeah, I literally just use my Xbox for watching movies and TV.
My PlayStation's battery shut out, so can't use it anymore.
Right after I sent her 5 PS games for Christmas.
Yeah. My sister was gonna play Dragon Age. Couldn't turn on.
I didn't know it had a battery.
Has to have somewhere to actually get the power that's being plugged into it.
Wouldn't that be a capacitor, not a battery?
Capacitor?
Electronics 101.
Don.
What?
I'm going to plug jumper cables up to your balls when we meet.
Kinky.
I'll make sure there's a video of that.
Oh, wow.
Important question, would they be plugged into the wall or a battery?
Probably yeah. Checking Pornhub.
Or into a capacitor.
Into the battery of Revenge's car.
Oh, I'm sorry, Don.
Yikes.
And there's jumper cables in the back of my Jeep, so I'm sorry, Don.
I'm kind of wondering why you have a ball torturing fetish.
People pay good money for it.
Who doesn't have a ball torturing fetish?
And now apparently we've gone to CBT.
Cognitive behavioral therapy.
So... Yeah, I love CBT.
That is.
I got home from work at about 6:43, so my apologies for being a little bit disorganized. Yeah, I got a fire off some emails still, so I've been working like a 13-hour day today. It's fun.
Understandable.
I know.
You had a long day yesterday,
too. I got nothing on Spocket, so I'm gonna fucking preach to the choir. If we want to... This is not at all intended to be a shot at anyone, but I think we will have success progging with multiple spirit link totems, so I would appreciate if a healer could sit to roll with two shamans. I know Dawn sat for Sledgefist.
I can sit tonight.
Yeah, I don't mind either.
I already volunteered.
Difficulty's still on heroic, by the way, Lex.
I think.
Sorry about that.
Word on the street is, I think Don's looking for some extra time to work on his new monk.
That actually isn't a bad idea. That's a little more forward thinking than sitting Nazala, I think. Granted, he would be doing it.
I'm guessing no word from Kane.
Oh yeah, Kane's not raiding anymore. For at least the next month, which I have no timeline beyond that. What else? What else do we do here?
Are we extended?
Yeah, it should be extended. Maybe I have to zone in first, but I've already extended my lockout, so I would love a summon.
Are we good to zone in?
Yep, we're good.
Yeah, I'm also going to ask one of our mages to sit. Can do a good old-fashioned roll, do whatever. I don't really care. If anyone wants a night off, has stuff they could take care of, let me know.
I'll sit. I just moved into a new house. I'll get some stuff set up.
Sounds good to me. That makes my life easy.
Good luck.
Thank you.
I'll be around if you need it. Appreciate some things.
I'm wondering if this leaves us very low redundancy for Mass Dispel. I'm not wondering. I know it does.
It's all good. I just won't die.
Hell yeah.
There's a slight delay between the first and second too.
Yeah, it should be fine too.
Yeah, I think the timing was pretty good.
I know how to make it not suck if it comes to it.
I think maybe we just bring in Lai.
Well, all the healers can spell too. So it sort of like a mass dispel if everyone dispels.
True.
Like,
yeah, I mean that's true. Yeah, let's try with this. We'll try with this and see how it goes. Make adjustments if we need. Really, I'm just looking for us to have a lot higher DPS on the Goliath and a lot higher priority on the, I don't even know their names, the Skirmishers, when they're low.
Yeah, I looked at that point when you mentioned the video where they, and I was like, what is their DPS right there? And I was like, yeah, we're not hitting that DPS.
It's funny, because Max goes out of his way to say that their DPS is low in that guild.
Well, the thing is, in most of the logs, the DPS on the first Goliath was really high, and then much lower on the second Goliath. And I don't know if it's just because the
maybe we're not balancing cooldowns enough. Yeah, that could be a possibility.
You're also double PI on someone in the second one.
You're also missing another Boomy with a CA Convoke as well.
True.
I mean, it doesn't feel that great, honestly.
So what I'm gonna do is we're gonna actually have Habit delay his Wild Spirits and True Shot until the second set.
Poggers, I'll sit for you all.
And I will run with that Shaman whenever you want to pass it gear.
Hopefully that helps a little bit.
The one problem with only having one priest is now we don't have any backups for casting Fort, which I've proven I'm pretty bad at.
True.
We'll just start screaming for it before every goal.
And I'll just,
I'll give you a weak aura macro. Where I just slam it repetitively saying fort.
I hate whisper macros in general. Like, Wayo's got one on intervene, and like every time he intervenes to me, I'm like, ooh, a message from Wayo. Oh, I get my hopes up that it's gonna be exactly. Oh, this is sad.
Yeah, there was a holy paladin who, like, he had a whisper macro set up for everything he did. So when he was sacking the tanks, we'd get a nice leveling message from him. And we're like, we already know the sack is on us.
I threatened one of our old tanks with putting Iron Bark in a whisper macro.
Oh, I would have killed you if you'd done that.
Because you would have gotten it outside of raid.
I know. You never Iron Bark me in raid, but yeah, okay. In Mythic Plus.
Let's run with what we have. Groups 1-4 right now. Lie, depending on how things are going, I'm definitely open to bringing you in if people are fucking up. Not bringing their A game. So we'll start with this.
Are there 3 or 4 weak auras for this fight?
12.
The really key ones are the the dunk one is needed by generally a raid leader.
I have the soak one.
The soak one is mandatory.
The seismic upheaval one, and I have the wicked blade one. I'm not sure if I'm missing something though.
No, you're not for DPS. Well, the dunk one is good, actually.
What is that one?
It's the one that shows what Renathal's energy is at and how long people have left on their orbs.
Yes, thank you. Thanks for the link, Nemia.
Okay, let's start.
My WoW crash, one sec. And what was a fire? All the loneliness got me feeling tired.
This aching in my chest. It's like a live wire. Taking all my strength to hold back. We're on slots. We can maybe, if we only have one tank, we maybe want to keep it to, you know. Yeah, well. I'm double Ravenous Feasted. That's fucking pog, dude. Glad I... Oh, I thought I preemptively onk-totemed myself. That would have been clutch. Oh, preemptively onk-totemed Slamson. Nice. Oh, this next Ravenous Hunger target is fucked. Or Ravenous Feast. Yeah. Oh yeah, good night, all three of you. Damn.
Oh, hell. Oh yeah, the pod.
It's always me, too.
Yeah.
Imagine not preemptively bubbling.
I did it on the first one that hit me.
Nice.
That's definitely soul stoning.
Didn't that happen Sunday, too?
Yep.
Every time.
Oh shit, they nerfed Warlocks.
Mm-hmm. What do you mean? Hell yeah.
You're just figuring us.
We're deleted.
Are you talking about the PTR?
They canceled Warlocks. They didn't just nerf them.
Yeah, 18% base nerf, and then to our conduit, that also another 10% nerf.
Yeah, that's cancel culture level nerf. Holy shit, dude. No better time than now to roll an elemental shaman, though. Straight up boomers.
All hail stat scaling.
I think you mean Shadow Priest.
Shadow Priest is bad on this fight, but good in general.
The more priests we have, the more we can give them a lot of power infusion.
Power infusion has to be the only good thing about this priest.
Oh, don't talk about disc like that.
They're adding 30 more seconds to Spirit Shell. Like, they're just nerfing it into the ground.
Why are they nerfing everything when the content is so fucking hard?
I don't know.
They didn't nerf Paladins.
Didn't touch Paladins.
Didn't get touched today.
Just you wait.
It's time to whip out the Holy Paladins, guys.
I might have done a dance when I saw the Boomkin nerfs.
My Holy Paladin is better geared than my Druid is now.
I mean, they also kind of nerfed casters with the double on use now.
This is racism.
They want their new double on use?
So they really want the healer core to be only Resto Shamans.
They made the cooldown
for... Did they touch
for...
Resto Shamans?
Not yet.
Not a lick.
Pog, dude.
They also didn't touch Resto Druid, which I'm suspicious about.
Because they can fix like how strong Resto Shamans are right now. Just by changing how the fights work a lot of times. Like, so many of these fights are literally just Spirit Link is the god cooldown because everything's so, like, together. Like, making y'all have to rely on, like, Riptide and shit a little bit more. I know that it's already, like, primary of your healing. You guys are crushing on numbers, but, like, there's a lot of fight design stuff.
Shaman's always been a good utility healer, but they also have the numbers.
We're already...
Yeah, exactly.
Into late territory. There's Phantas runes in the DVA items tab. There's stacks of pots. Grab some health pots. Let's clean up this bank tab. Turn it into more of a dank tab. We can dank gank it.
Jesus, no.
He's going.
How many White Claws did you crack into before Raid Lux?
Fucking.
You said it's been a long day at work,
dude. Yeah. It has, truly.
You said White Claw.
White Claw?
Yeah. Truly's a totally different brand.
Truly.
Oh my god.
Yeah, so things we can improve on are definitely the damage profiles on high priority targets. You know, maybe we have a more in-depth discussion around holding CDs until the Goliaths are low, if we really need to. Pillow, I want your Spirit Link. Now, in the video, they hold theirs for the second set of the Mass Dispel. We're going to try using ours on the second set of Dispels. We might need a Priest for that. Or sorry, we might need a second Priest, but generally, for right now, we'll just wait till the master spell goes out, and then we'll spirit link the second application of the debuffs.
Try to pay attention to what is left on my cooldown when it gets to the same time that I when it gets to the meteor drop or the crystallized the second time around. I'll let you know if there's any adjustments you need to be made.
Sounds good. Can we? You know, I think we're good. Everyone's ready, it looks like.
E1 Spirit Link on the second Master Spell, right?
Yeah, so I'll hit the first one and then we'll have you go on the second one and we'll adjust as needed.
Okay.
Three people are missing Vantus runes. I strongly recommend you, Vantus.
Hell yeah, dudes.
Heckin' Spencer. Yeah. Pillow, weapon buff.
There are oils, health pots, whatever you need in the guild bank. Also, can you guys not, like stop putting in, like, green gems into the items tab, please? Like...
That's not me, I promise.
I appreciate it, but at the same time... Slam, are you ready, my guy?
Yep.
I actually gotta change the talent real quick.
What's that? Oh, pillow. Also, if you're not running it, Windrush Totem is really good on this fight.
Yep, I got it going.
I'm going to get the first set of adds when they're low.
Ag, you're tanking, boss. I'm
Sparky's going to get the second.
That's one change we made up from last week.
Okay, potentially then we shouldn't even need mine, but I can, I'll be back up though.
Okay. And then what we're going to try and do, we might have to see how much damage our tanks are taking going into the phase, because Nimios was getting dicked when he had stacks. But we want to have the boss hit 50% before the third set of skirmishers. That's kind of our benchmark on boss damage, friends.
What was the tank swap change for?
Oh, warriors are just better snap aggroing AoE targets because of Thunderclap and shit, so.
Well, that was just for bear, I guess.
I think we can go back to whatever was working for you guys. I don't really have a preference.
Or either way. Do you still want me to misdirect all the ads to you when they come out?
All right, I'll take boss then.
Okay.
Oh wait, so do you want to reset for lust? Or we did.
No, we're fine. We're fine.
We're good. Yeah.
Let's get
Decree is up for every ad spawn, so.
Cool. Let's do it.
Five, four, three, two, one.
Yeah, and we're tanking a little bit closer to the middle of the room than the wall than we were last time, so. Make sure you're in a position where you can make a play with, or if you get Wicked Blades, which is happening in 2 seconds.
I used my Windrush on accident.
No, it's a great time to use it.
I'm covered. I use mine as well. I didn't react to the audio cue. I apologize. So here's where we would get the MD. We would get in. Yeah, so the MD has to be...
Yeah, I got the blades in the middle of my ramp and just ended up in a ridiculous position.
Fair enough. All right. We definitely do not want to stack those. We get her up. I think MDing with Spirit Link up is a higher priority than your ramp. I don't care about your overall healing, etc.
Okay. We'll probably need to individually dispel this next one.
Yeah. This is where we would do Spirit Link. I'm dispelling Nimios. And we soak. Yeah, that's fucked with the Goliath low, but not dead.
Is that too slow or too fast?
Call Shadow Forces is happening in 3 seconds. Maybe we're...
Too slow.
Yeah, we should have skipped this set of ads.
Yeah, this is too slow.
Let's just keep trying it out. Fine. So this is the set we would ideally want. Spock Agary to AMZ or AMS. I'm dispelling you. Fuck. I did it too soon, I guess. Watch out for Sauce. Anima, line in. We're all on Goliath here. Well, skirmishers right now, but.
That's the one we grip, right?
Yeah. We just had a lot of people that didn't clear, so. I really want to watch their full walkthrough and see, like, just... Are they getting the second set of heart rends on the first, with the first Goliath still alive?
Speaking of Heartrend, does anyone have a weak wire that can tell me when it gets dispelled off of me? Because I would like something that will tell me that so that I can use a defensive. Because I think just that this last pull, I died after it was dispelled because I also had the bleed on me. And I didn't realize
The Goliath was low. We literally couldn't heal anyone.
Yeah, it was just really poor lineup.
Yeah, no, no, I'm saying like, so I can use the defensive, so I don't die. Because if I know when it gets dispelled, then I'm like, okay, cool, let me pop this thing.
You'll just need a debuff for a debuff tracker. It's called Heart Hemorrhage.
What number of Goliath was that?
The one that just came out was the second.
Yeah, so they pushed. Even with not using the strategy that Jelly suggested, they pushed the Goliath. Sorry. Their boss was at literally 53% when the Goliath died. Okay.
Since we have a second link now, I'm not barriering number two anymore. Don't we still line up tonight?
Ideally, we want to barrier number two because we don't want to use our link on number two.
Gotcha. So we want to keep the AMZ barrier for the second.
Yeah, we generally want to use spirit link on the third one. But yeah, so I'm looking, literally the only difference in our strategy from the one that Max had in that full walkthrough video is that they're DPS. They're literally, the boss is at 52% when the second Goliath dies, and they're killing it 38 seconds before the third set of heart rends are going out. Our Goliath died, and we got the heart rends almost immediately after. So that's really the only significant difference, I think. Let's keep rolling. I'm getting a food buff. Sorry.
The second heart rend coming out.
Sorry?
When does the second heart rend come out for AMZ?
It's just on a timer. I think it's probably about 50 seconds into the fight. Heart rend is every 40 seconds, so a minute and a half, I guess.
It'll come out really soon after the crystallize happens. So, like, basically, as soon as the crystallize starts to get channeled, it's about a second after that the heart rends go out on players.
Okay, everyone is ready. Let's try saving our cooldowns on the Goliath until it's around 40% on the second one.
Do you want me to say Wild Spirits?
Ready.
To them?
Yeah, sure.
Alright, cool.
Oh, shit, it's like food buffing.
No worries. Let's hit it. Oh, we also need Battle Show when you're ready, Sean.
Five, four, three, two, one.
Goliath is up. Hermes.
Four, three, one.
This is empty. And crystallize. So far away as melee that you didn't get hit by the MD. It's troll as fuck, dude.
I'm not melee.
Oh, you're playing elemental?
Five, four.
That's also troll as fuck, dude.
It's not working.
still have 5 seconds left on him.
Yeah. That link felt a little bit early. Okay, so this is clearly just not working at all. We are not dispelling.
I was confused. I thought he said 5 seconds left on it, and then I kind of counted to five.
Yeah.
That's why I blinked and it just didn't come out. Oh, he blue screened.
One.
We skipped the skirmishers though.
Hell yeah, dude.
I didn't see how far off we were.
But at what cost?
I tried something a little different to see if it would help with that. Lex, I just stayed full single target blasting any aim shot I could get into that boss and doing then the trick shots. To try to see if we could push it a little lower so we could, you know, do the transition earlier.
Fair.
So, food for thought if you want me to keep doing it. I just, you know.
Yeah, I think when we are in wild spirits, we should be doing that anyways, using trick shots.
Well, yeah, I mean, us and trick shots on this fight is incredible.
Well, if we can replicate that timing right there, the Goliath was like at 10% when we faced the boss. That's...
I think what's happening
absolutely
is
massive.
A lot of people are just getting the, okay, that whole Goliath needs to die, which is good. Skirmishers need to die, good. But then no one's doing like actual upfront damage to that boss.
Yeah, no, totally makes sense. I think I'll join you on that.
Yeah, and see if we can get a good push going, because especially with we do the first round, so all our stuff is done, so we can just do our standard rotation into it.
Yeah. I didn't see what the boss percentage was when the Goliath died, but I know on other pulls, when we have had the skirmishers, after the first Goliath died, the boss was at like 78%-ish. I don't know what it was this time around, but I think if we need to get it to like 76 when the first Goliath dies for us not to screw through.
Desai, are you set on using lock and load and stream focus? Day focus? Oh. You set on using that?
Though I probably should swap to my trick shots covenant or whatever it's called conduit, but I haven't done that yet.
I don't know. I'm thinking volume might be better here because
yeah,
it allows you to do more trick shots without wasting energy on multi shot.
Mm-hmm.
True. And then using conduit percentage with the streamline's not too bad.
Multi-shot is also quite a bit of damage.
But I think it comes with the trinkets you're using, because I'm using the Ceph, the overcharge and my battery.
You have way more haste. That makes sense.
Yeah,
I'm using that as well.
I don't have that one. I have not been blessed with trinket.
The hunters are using the Awakener's Frond, the 203 thing they get off of the tributes.
That?
Yeah, that one. Yeah.
Yeah, I only got a 194 of it, so...
Fading. The 194 is available tonight, Fader.
Everyone's ready. Everyone is ready, friends. I think we might need to get the second priest in. I don't know.
I'm gonna try some meme talents for this pull.
Five, four.
Also, pillow three, ancestral protection totem is pretty good here. One. You can get two uses, and it's generally pretty easy to predict when someone's about to get cucked.
Okay.
Four, three, two, one.
good stuff. Pump the damage here. Pump the damage. Oh, someone was too close. That was still within 8 yards, I think. I respect the effort. It was just a little bit too close to the sun.
Five, four, three, two,
one. So this is your link, yeah. Yeah, I mean, that's totally fine. We just need to make sure we kill the Goliath very shortly after, or our tanks are going to get absolutely shit on here. We got a third Goliath, or no, we're phased. Okay, perfect. And we, oh, we got the juice. Sparky, yeah. Take the juice in. We need a warlock portal from the Jizzinator. Someone just jumped off? This was not a wipe.
It knocked me off.
You were too close to the front.
Yeah.
Yeah, if you're too close to Renathal, you get knocked back, by the way.
You have to be by circle.
Yeah. Everyone should be pretty close to circle, honestly. And then this is the set we would ideally want to mass dispel. But now we can't. So this is, we're life gripping this. We're life grip on whoever that was on, Tenenbaum.
Tenenbaum.
Don't soak that. Yeah.
Five.
I forgot that was also where we have to use wild spirits on these guys, right?
Yeah.
Is it four commandos we want to flex before we do that?
Three or four is fine. Okay. It's a random number. Yeah.
So, I tried something that pull that I think will be really good for this fight, which was convoking with full CDs before the first Goliath even spawns, because it's so good as a single target cooldown, but just pumping that damage into the boss right off the bat, especially if all three of Boomies did that.
Then we just don't have damage for the Goliath though.
But everyone else can cover.
Are you sure? You know?
I feel like we absolutely could.
So we want a warlock portal from around Nipple to Mr. Renathal. Also, yes, for people who learned the hard way that pull, when Renathal gets anima dunked into him on Mythic, he does a substantial knockback around him. And if you're like halfway between Renathal and the raid, he's just going to knock you off. So you have to be pretty tight on the Nipple area.
You're either here or like...
Sorry? The portal can take you right in. That's not a problem. I'm going to be calling who dunks. It's additional clarity, you only dunk when told on Mythic. It's not like everyone just runs to the boss. Because if two people go at once, then you knock the person who's running off. T1 crystallize is just close to the raid. So we just determined that we want to be closer to the raid. And people who don't need to clear their bleeds will have to adjust accordingly. Because if you move to circle, then it's really hard for the tanks to clear their stacks, which is shit. We need the tanks to be able to clear their stacks. It's high prio. Does that make sense, sir?
I've been able to clear all my stacks. Sometimes I have to run a little bit farther than I would like, which I think actually drops DPS uptime because you guys are chasing the fucking boss because I'm running to Kansas to get my stacks cleared.
Right. Can we get the shout? Thank you.
Yeah. Four people missing feast. Feast up.
You clear every time, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Everyone is ready. That was a good pull. Honestly, that was perfect DPS on the Goliath again. We're walking a dangerous line here. Because if we have pulls like that where the Goliath is at like 25%, we're going to have two Goliaths up at the same time, which is really bad. But, I mean, fuck. If it ain't broke, People also need to make a plan for Wicked Blade, maybe stand a little closer to the boss if they're not as mobile. If they are mobile, it's fine.
Five, two, one.
Why are we? It seems like we're still trying to put the thing on circle.
No, he's just getting pushed, trying to still do damage, I think. Someone was in between the boss and the Wicked Blade again. Unlucky.
Five, four, three, two, one.
Yeah, so people are gonna need to mega clear here. This is the one where we get barrier, Devo, or etc. It's now that it's. That worked. We probably didn't want to link there, but it's all good.
That was the MD, though.
Yeah, generally we're trying to not link there. We're trying to just use barrier and Devo.
Oh, okay.
Five,
okay, someone
four,
literally just
three,
moved into the boss's
two,
hitbox and took the
one.
Wicked Blade. I don't know if that was a tank or what, but...
It was me.
It might have been because I was moving Kale to triangle.
It's all good. That's
if you
a great
take your ability
damage. We skipped the skirmishers and had the Goliath dead.
But we killed the Goliath before we pushed Kale.
That's totally fine. Not relevant. Not something that is required for success on this boss. If we're pushing at either of those timings where we get the Goliath dead, the Goliath is sub 10% and we push and we get the sauce, that's great. If the Goliath dies before we push, but we still don't get the third set of skirmishers, that's equally as great. All right, we're up for the challenge on both. Okay, those are both successful push timings in my eyes. Yeah, Ravager, I could see being fucking dank on this fight.
Yeah, I picked up Dragonroar too just to see how it's going, and I got like a round of like 13k crits on skirmishers. It's pretty nice.
I wouldn't mind the chance to try Elemental on this fight. Absolutely, just dump all my anima into Gaul.
Is that worth playing with us these days?
Yeah. It's my pickup line on Tinder.
You swiping during raids?
No, I don't do that. I also just haven't eaten since like 10:30 in the morning, so I'm too tired to swipe. It requires a certain amount of energy. Everyone's ready.
I'm just shaking my head at you.
Battle shout, please. What the fuck do you mean spell weave?
You have to do...
I think he's about Master of Elements and then like the Surge.
You can't do shit willy-nilly.
I mean, technically, all you need really is Storm Elemental and Chain Lightning and Earthquake right now.
Rocks ready.
With Flame Shock.
It's more than that.
It's not that complex, my guy. You want to try to have your Master of Elements procs on Earthquake.
Four,
it's not
three,
the end of the world.
Master
Steph.
One.
Yeah. It's really not the end of the world if you don't maximize Master of Elements. It's the difference between like a 99 and like an 80 parse, maybe.
I'm playing Earthquake like Legendary, and you have to use the Earthshock first.
Now, well, then, there you go. Wickets. Must get out. Oh, I think you guys were too close to each other.
No,
or maybe I just got jumped on.
I got jumped on.
Okay,
two,
that's fine.
One.
Clear your stacks. get in. Okay, we need more people to soak there. That was stress. Look at blades.
I'm gonna drag him out a little bit and reposition. Sorry, melee.
It's fine. You're good. Second glide this up. Boss is pretty low. We gotta definitely pump into this Goliath a little bit, guys.
Two, one.
Wrens are out. Wicked Blades. It's a Sparky's totem.
Where are we taking it? Circle or?
You just want to stay close to the raid.
Okay.
You're dead anyways, so. We get revenge up.
I'm gonna move after the next Wicked Blades.
Circle.
Everyone fuck me, circle. Right?
Four.
Yeah, someone dunked.
Two. One.
It's fine. So this is where we would mass dispel these and we would spirit link. Do we not have the timer on MD? Okay, do we spirit link now? That's perfect.
That was
no,
Commando.
No, get that out, get
Commando.
That out, get that out.
Commando.
Life grip habit.
I feel like I should be soaking that one, but that'll probably kill me, right?
You'll die.
Yeah.
Alright, we did not push the commando in time, that's okay.
Five, four, three.
We might need to do a tank swap there then, because I'm already sitting at like three stacks by the time that comes.
We should be okay.
It's a lot of commandos.
One thing I noticed in the video is that they kill the second set of skirmishers before the Goliath hits 30. And
yeah.
If you pull,
I think that's
really fucks us.
Yeah, I think that that's actually a really important thing to note. Yeah, we should start doing that, killing the skirmishers before the Goliath hits 30, because that's just a super ghetto situation.
So was I not supposed to dunk there when the Goliath dropped his orb?
It was really bad timing because, well, A, we don't want our tank being the one who's dunking, and B, we were doing Wicked Blades and the boss was not repositioned, so we had to move like into the middle of the room to do Wicked Blades, kind of. So I think you knocked both of us off. Well, if not both of us, you definitely knocked me off.
Or mass a spell.
I think someone died to a second Wicked Blade that hit him. Like the first one hit him and the second one hit him.
Maybe.
That was Lex.
Real quick, no, I died to getting knocked off.
Real quick, master spell stuff. I'm able to get the first two since the dispel is always timed with the crystallize coming out. For the third one, since the timing is before the crystallize, there's about 5 seconds on MD left up. So I either have to MD late for that one, or we need to individually dispel people.
I think we just need to get a second priest, but.
We'll
potentially make that adjustment on the break. Okay, that was fine. I think Uber's suggestion is the most prominent thing to focus on for this poll. Get the second set of skirmishers down before pushing that Goliath to 30% is really key. And yeah, I mean, if we have to make the adjustment where our tank is dying and we have to soak that first crystallize, that can be done because I think it overlaps with the spirit link timing slightly. Or I mean, it's survivable. It just generally is not great to take that amount of damage. But if it's going to save our tank's life, then that's totally fine. And we can life grip the crystallize after that, like the fourth one, if we need to. So let's play around with that.
Alright, I will life grip when you tell me to then.
Well,
like, are we letting. It's dependent upon whether the tanks have bleeds and need to clean them off, right?
Two.
Yeah, one. I think it's something that we need to get a,
I can just keep an eye
a touchy out. Feel for.
Yep.
People are still right. Splashing bleeds on Wicked Blades. Unless that was like a bunch of leaps all at once.
It's just leaps on this. Oh, I'm super bad. I
am indeed a second too early.
Yeah, I wasn't paying attention there either. I didn't have Spirit Link down. I literally was just tunneling, listening.
Right.
We can just wipe.
Is that enough soaks too?
I have no idea. I normally have Spirit Link down there, so.
At least we have the quick wipe of just jump off the edge.
Everyone really should be making an effort to soak on this fight. For the non-life grip crystallizes.
I think in general, if people stack up tighter, like range and melee, there's no reason we can't just like uber stack and then it's really easy to make sure that nobody is going to be out of position for getting hit by Wicked Blades coming back.
There are going to be times where people get pushed away a little bit because it's not worth them canceling their cast to stick that tight to the raid if nothing's really happening. But also, as a general rule, yes.
I think a tighter stack just makes it easier to hit MDs. It makes it easier to land spirit links and stuff. People are like, I don't know why people are spreading out as much as they are.
I'm personally moving around just because it makes it easier to thaw things up. Make sure everything's ready. But I also have a way to get back with me.
Though us by, I met girls, you met guys. We both took some time to find ourselves. Though I want you back, I know we can't go back. Cause breaking up was necessary. Everyone's ready.
I got a new chair and it's really comfortable, but it's the wrong height.
In like which it's direction?
Like, it's like bring your kid to work
Five,
day.
4, 3, 2, 1.
Wicked Blades.
We're also trying not to have crystallized like inside the wall.
That was totally fine, I think. There's no problems with that crystallized. Okay, someone got hit again. I think that might be one of our tanks just too close to the hitbox of the of call. Not really seeing any stray parties. We would all want to clear here. Okay, that's good. I think you just cast barrier before, honestly, just for like sequencing.
It's a lot easier for me to do when I'm not also the crystallized person, since like
true
four globals that true. I'm trying to.
Yeah, no, I feel that spiritually. Yeah. Okay, someone pumped us again.
The boss was way too close to the wall, too.
Yeah, it was.
Fair. It was probably a wipe either way, but I think we still skipped our third skirmisher timing there, which is sick.
We did it. Yeah, because when we came out of the skirmishers being down, we were at 51 or 52 on call.
I think the timings are getting a lot better.
I've been only attacking the boss like as my main target since you did that change, and
yeah,
I think it's been better.
It made a hell of a difference, and with both of us, the timing has felt really good each time, or at least it seems to be.
Just to clarify on what I was talking about for the crystallized thing, because like I'm getting two conflicting pieces of information from folks in the raid, so I kind of want to clear up what our priority is. Like, it's going to be like, here, let me mark myself real quick. So if I'm the crystallized target and I'm standing here, like a third of the circle is inside of this wall and people can't stand in it. If you get blown over here, it's fine. It's just like now the back third of the circle is like out in this direction. And
I'm confused.
Why do we need all?
Why
that's
relevant though. Yeah.
Okay. Do me a favor, Nuzala. You don't have F flow. Can you drop a F flow here on me just to show you what I'm talking about? Pretend this is the crystallized, right? If I'm tank, like you guys want the boss tanked out here. If I'm blown even a little bit, I miss my soak. It means I have to be standing here so that the blow doesn't like knock me out, because the way that circle geometry works, like I can't.
Right.
If the crystallize is in here, then the boss is always going to be tanked too close.
That's fair.
And I think a lot of it also is when the boss starts coming in, and at least from my perspective, is I'm going to keep backing up to keep things in front of me so I can attack them. And then you're ending up with the crystallize on that wall because the boss keeps coming. So it's like they play against each other, basically.
I would just, like, if crystallize is out here, it means I can tank the boss out here and not worry about getting blown out of the crystallize soak, right? Like, it's only when I'm out here where it's even, like, a little bit off and I miss the soak and then my bleeds are fucked. Like, the reason I'm tanking in so close is because the crystallize is getting closer and closer to the wall, so I have to come in closer. Because the last two raid nights, I've missed clearing my debuffs because I got blown out of the circle.
I think that's a good point. But I will say that I think it's a timing issue still. Like, the skirmishers are dying at the wrong time.
A little bit closer to the wall than we were on, like, even Sunday night.
Yeah,
yeah,
the,
I think
the boss
think
is
the
going steadily
just
closer, like, here in this path. Like, it's on this row of boxes.
Yeah, I think we want the boss more, like, somewhere, like, where I'm jumping right now.
Yeah, that's pretty much what the videos that I've watched show.
I'm fine to tank it out that far. It's just crystallizes routinely over here, which is not fun to try to get to.
Yeah.
So
no, I agree.
I think that's the timing issue, though, is what I'm saying.
Like, how is that a timing issue, though?
Skirmishers are dying at the wrong time.
Like, but the thing is, how is that a timing issue if
it's
someone over here?
It's not a timing issue. It's super hard to control. There's not going to be like a static, the skirmishers die at this time every fight. That's like impossible to consider.
I'm not saying that's what it is.
I have the talking stick now.
I'm not.
Let's pull.
I'm not like attacking what you're saying, Freelink. I'm saying that it's going to be inconsistent for how the skirmisher pushback overlaps with the crystallize. There's going to be some pulls where we're not getting pushback. There's going to be some pulls where we are getting pushback. It's impossible to try to coordinate your damage when you're cleaving to that level. It's just not worth like getting into that. It's fine to have the pushback during the crystallize. It's just the point is that the crystallize needs to be edging closer to the boss and slightly behind it versus closer to the wall. That's just the point that's being made in general. Whether or not that's happening during a pushback is fairly irrelevant.
Yes, sir. Yeah, the only thing I was trying to say is if people are complaining the boss is too close, and I'm trying to say pull the
cast it when they're basically, like when the crystallized timer ticks down to 3, you can cast Master Spell and it'll hit everything and won't have any problem.
Can we get Intellect, please? Tenon Bomber, you good to go?
Let's do this.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
We are on the Goliath. Getting Wicked Blades out. Crystallize is out. We're going to get pushed here. Get in. Okay, I guess I just linked too soon. But I got stunned, so.
I also didn't get the Spirit Shell there because I got pounced literally as I hit the button for Spirit Shell, and so just was stunned for 5 seconds or whatever and didn't have any actual shields up on anybody.
Let's just jump off, we got too many healers dead.
Yeah. The Spirit Link definitely did not cover the whole heart rend there, so.
Did this change so you don't lose your ability when you fall to them? I just didn't lose your ability.
Friends and grab an extra flask.
Ag, make sure you've got a flask. Yours is about to pop.
Sam, are you good? Artorius, you good?
Yeah.
Okay, let's hit it.
Five, four, three, two, one.
Perfect. That's really good.
Melee, walk up, watch out. Back up from the boss.
We're gonna have more damage on the boss now that we've added an entire additional DPS player. Wanna try to kill the... This is Lai here, MDing. What is happening?
I'm liking this.
Yeah, that's totally fine. Respect that call.
I'm gonna try and go watch out for
this. This is perfect. That's a perfect push.
I think what happened was a Wicked Blades into Crystallize.
Remember, we just moved closer to the boss here with Wicked Blades. Don't stand on top. What are you guys doing? What? The Wicked Blades players literally just did that perfectly, and then three
people
just ran on top of them.
The boss for some reason.
Yeah.
That was my bad. That was like the first thing in that zone. He said run to the boss. I was like, okay.
That's fair.
I used my defense.
Oh, that's my bad.
Are we individually dispelling now?
Don't forget.
This is where we would want to MD and use Pillow's Link.
Pillow's Link is down though.
Yes, I understand that.
I need... All right, Lie, get ready to grip me. Grip me, please.
Thank you. Good job. We failed the commando. It's all good. Okay, so. Yeah, that was a little bit of an unclear call. So when Call is moved there, the Wicked Blades are just going to move basically slightly behind Call, like those two individuals did. That was a really good way to deal with the Wicked Blades there. I definitely blurted out an unclear call, and yeah,
followed aimlessly. That's good.
Yeah, it's fine. That was
so like five people stacking on top.
You gotta
of me.
Respect that kind like, of fuck, undying man. Blind loyalty.
Right?
Remember, stack the team, on moon.
Like said, move.
Yeah, that's kind of what I was talking about earlier. Is we're ending up with the commandos like super staggered in health because it's like people are killing one and then cleaving onto others and. So they're not all going to get their shield at the same time.
Yeah, the Goliath is super high prio target in the intermission phase, not the commandos until we have a certain amount. That is worth mentioning. We don't pop our 2-minute cooldowns until we have about three commandos.
There it was like we had one that had the shield up, we had another at 40, another at 70, and it was like, oh.
Hey, Lex, Lex, you did that thing where you auto-hammered when you can just use a repair mount.
Yeah, it's all gooch. That was good in terms of boss timing.
Also figured out another reason that having a second priest is good. And I got the third crystallize on me.
Yeah.
You always get crystallized, honestly.
I am.
I'm wondering if that's a good moment for like pain suppression on our tank.
I think we're gonna need to work out a pretty good external cooldown on me when I'm tanking Kale in intermission, because those stacks are gonna get pretty high unless we do a tank swap.
Is that the play going forward? Gripping whoever is gonna get the stun in the intermission.
On the third one, I usually have it, so don't worry about it unless it is me and a Hall in it, like last time.
Okay. So, but in the event that I get the AoE circle, I run out like you did, and then I get gripped again?
Bingo.
Yep.
What's the stacking debuff? Is it a stacking debuff that tanks get?
Yes.
What's it called?
Serrated tear or serrated swipe, something like that.
Is it the same one that everybody gets, or is it?
No, it's a different
one. Different one.
I just want to add it.
It's serrated tear.
Is there like a stack level that it just becomes a real problem?
Three or higher.
Three higher is bad. Can we get two and then we clear our second stack before we get our third using crystallizes? But because nobody's getting in the third crystallized, that's not going to happen. So I'll probably need an external for 3 and 4.
Is serrated tear the name of the debuff or the name of the ability that plays?
The debuff.
The debuff.
Gross.
The ability itself is serrated swipe.
Okay.
I honestly think in the intermission that the tanks might swap. Or maybe that's purely from last phase damage.
It's I'm tough looking to do at a logs. Tank swap only because it's like I would have to run in and AoE taunt all the fucking commandos off of Ag, and he would just like single taunt Kale off me, and the healers would have to just be...
I'm referring to when like the commandos die, the first set dies. And
oh, yeah, that could be a great spot to do it. I'll still at least get the third serrated.
Who knows?
I don't know if timing will work out for the fourth.
Yeah, I don't think it's that great of an idea now that I'm thinking of it with the commandos. Let's just try again. Just looking at logs, and both the tanks have similar damage taken from serrated blades or serrated tear, so I don't really know how that's possible without tank swapping, but maybe my knowledge of the fight sucks.
Are you looking at overall or just the first phase?
Looking at overall, but I can look at only the first phase.
Five, four, three, two, one.
We can probably have people get two potions in on this fight if they pot at the start, by the way. I think we should be doing that. Blades. Skirms are up. Heartrend coming out. Get ready for MD.
What's going on?
This is where we would want barrier and Pivo. That's perfect. If we can have that timing before this even goes off, try to keep this in the raid. Take that. I have no idea how the fuck you live there. That Goliath was below 100 million health. Guys, the boss. Yikes. It's
you
all
can't.
Good. It's
I
all
didn't
good.
Do it that time. You nah, can't pull the boss when I was trying to dodge it.
So this is where we would mass dispel and link. We would mass dispel and link.
Double commando.
Oh, and move for the sauce. Move for the sauce. Get out. Get out. Get out. Grip free link. Kill the volatiles. Don't show.
I need an external for this next thing.
We just didn't DPS the volatile stone shell. Like honestly, the damage didn't feel too bad on you there, even with 3 stacks. But yeah, I feel.
Oh,
you.
3's fine. And I honestly had enough of my own CDs left. Like I had shield wall, I could have eaten the 4th and probably survived.
The volatile stone shell is a wrap. if
is
it goes off,
I think we're cleaving too hard.
Yeah, we need a little bit more single target.
Yeah, that was my bad on moving the triangle. I didn't realize, like, I thought that the Wicked Blade targets were going to be in a spot where if I moved the boss to triangle, the blade would just come back to triangle and not hit anybody.
Yeah, that was a tough one. The boss literally moved as the blade was back in transit to the boss, and that's definitely, like, super challenging on all parties. That was improvement. You love to see it. I have no idea how you lived, Sean, when
my
that
health was at 10% for like 20 was
below 30% for like 35 fucking seconds. That was hilarious.
I was fucking playing Beethoven on my keyboard, dude.
Yeah, so that second Goliath, we definitely have to make sure that we're, you know, pumping into that once it gets to 30. I know we've decided we want to kill the skirmishers before the Goliath goes to 30%, but yeah. That was good, though.
Yeah.
Frog. Intermission strat is we burn the Goliath until the we have about four commandos up, and then what we do is we try to cleave everything down pretty equally unless the Goliath is like below 30% health, and then once the commandos hit around 50%, we want all of our about 60 whatever percent, we want all of our 2-minute classes to pop their cooldowns for a second time. And we just nuke the fuck out of all the commandos with all of our 2-minute classes popping their cooldowns. Does that make sense?
Yeah, like ideally when, say, like they're all at 50%, what should the Goliath be at?
Super low.
Like sub 30? Like it should be almost dead by the time we do it?
It should be pretty much almost dead.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah. Like especially just for healing our tanks in that phase, we really need the Goliath to die quickly. I mean, what we could honestly do is we could literally use an ancestral prot totem to keep, to like just have our tank be like, fuck my life. Like, we have two ancestral prot totems. I've been generally using mine on our second set of heart rends because it's been a little stressful. But I think if we can get in the habit of saving it there, then I can use my ancestral prot to just save Sean's life.
I have a tuft of smoldering plumage I can use as well if we wanted to do that.
Yeah. I haven't switched into prot yet, or the totem.
Just I've been hitting rallying cry
that
for this.
Where you are using yours is the only place I've seen that's kind of shaky so far, but we haven't gotten that far yet.
How do you feel about rallying cry in the second heart run?
Yeah, I like that, honestly. I think it's super helpful.
Five. Four,
could even potentially three, save two, Ash and Hollow one. For that, but I like it on the first set still. Big on Goliath here. Wicked Blades in two. Crystallize is out, and that's a sick MD, my guy. That's the dank timing right there. That's what we love to see. Get out.
Back up, melee.
Goliath. Gonna be partner end in a few here. If we can get these MDs and barrier and AMZ off immediately.
Are we delaying just a bit for those?
Nope, we want to do it immediately.
I missed part.
Yeah, I was out of the raid. I'm fine, it's fine. I have personal cooldown. And we get in, clear our debuffs. That's definitely stress when the Goliath is super low but not dead.
Next serrated blade, I'll move Kale to
boss.
Triangle.
Yeah, bosses.
I just didn't want to move right when this
we're
happened.
On Goliath here.
Don't cleave it.
Watch
don't
out for
cleave it.
Blades.
Don't cleave
watch
it.
Out for
back up,
blades.
Melee, back up, melee.
Watch out for animas. Sauce. Big sauce.
Our runs are out.
Now, this is group for Mass Dispel and Spirit Link.
I got to jump.
Watch out for Anima, get him up. Philo, did you swap to Totem? No, you didn't.
Not yet, yeah. No.
Get out.
I'm going to, though, after this.
Grip Tenabomb. You just died, never mind. I think a Commando pumped you in the bum.
Me?
No. No, Tenant Bomb. Actually, I think a commando, he had aggro on a commando or something. I don't know. That was weird.
With rare Wayo is the commandos, some of them spawn over there and they instantly want to go to him.
True.
I tried misdirecting him, but I could not rip him off you.
We definitely want our commando stack to be like closer to Wayo. So we want our commando stack to be like in between like nipple and diamond, preferably to star. Star is too far away for our commando stack.
So it's right around then that we're going to basically, we're sacrificing Wayo and then bringing him back up a totem, right?
Yeah, I think that that's a totally fine play to do that.
Okay. Yeah, exactly. Usually, where is Wayo then during intermission?
Triangle.
Triangle. Okay.
I like that Lex is comfortable with me being the sacrificial lamb. What about to ask me how I felt about it?
Feels like every raid here, we have to sacrifice at least one thing.
Yeah, that's fine. Honestly, the Splintered Hearts saved me quite a few times, so... Maybe it'll pull through this time.
Grip and slappy hands are not the same. We can use a single target grip on the commando if needed. Yeah, for sure.
In the video, the limit one, they were single target gripping skirmishers in?
Yeah, the one that spawns at triangle. They gripped that one in?
They gripped two out of the three, I think. But we've only got one decay, so.
Yeah. Yeah, so the one that spawns at star is fine, and then they would grip in the one that spawns at triangle, and then naturally let the one at skull come in just so their health was slightly staggered. So they just created like a natural stagger on health. We get battle shocked. Yeah, slam. I don't know what's causing that. Maybe people are unfamiliar with. I mean, maybe that's one commando we just need to nuke when they get the spirit shell, and we don't have like cooldowns up for that point, but. It's gonna be a little
Five,
sketchy.
4, 3, 2, 1.
Wicked Blades in 5. Stuff. Careful, Link's Goliath is out.
Boss is a little closer, melee back up.
Don't kill someone. Yep, this.
That's fucked. I'm pretty sure that was me, and it hit me like as he was throwing it at them.
It's
just
fine.
Like me being behind him.
We're all gonna have to clear in this next one. we're just gonna healing dive here. Okay. Just have to have everyone clear. Sorry.
I'm linking it.
Yeah. Right. I guess. I don't really think Link is the play there. It was a little stressful though, so I feel that. Like, as long as we make it through those debuffs, there's literally no damage being taken there. Careful for blades. And then we move boss. Yeah. Care boss moved a little bit. Watch out for sauce. Watch out for sauce. This is where we MD. Pop arsenals since we have no spirit link. They got hit by sauce as well. Let's just get out.
That was the three stack.
Gripping into Saya.
Oh,
yep. Both of our priests were dead or something. I don't know.
One of them was dead and didn't realize.
I should have called that out.
Yeah, this is probably where we would sack Wayo.
Yeah, I get it out. He doesn't die.
Yeah. Well, if we don't DPS down that shell, then we're gonna die every time. So I think as soon as one of them starts hitting the shell, we should just all pop our cooldowns there, even if it's lower.
First one or second one?
Well, I don't know. I'm not really paying attention to the...
Okay, because that time, like, I switched off...
The first one.
We got the first one no problem without any... It didn't look like any CDs were flying. And then the second one, I think, might be the play.
So we definitely needed to have CDs rolling. If we didn't there, like if people were trying to still save them to optimize there, like you need to use them before the shell goes off so we have them rolling for when it starts.
Well, yeah, I think once the first Goliath shells, that's when everybody's...
Well, the Goliath, I don't think the Goliath shells, yeah, but like, once the Goliath hits 30%, we need to have CDs big dickin, king bickin, any of those.
Okay, that makes sense why the first one went down, since Sparky was doing that.
I think we just had a lot of sauce deaths there.
I think the one downside about four healing this is we won't actually see, like, it's the last phase that'll make or break four healing when we're tanking both at the same time, you know?
Yeah, but I mean, we're failing damage on commandos with four healers, so yeah. Five healing it makes that even more challenging.
Okay, let's go down to three healers, yeah?
Fucking down, boys. These are the kinds of suggestions we live for.
I mean, for Motherford, we only need two healers. We just need Master Spell, and we need Link.
Pillow just needs to hand his Spirit Link totem to Lex, and then we need a Disc Priest and a double Spirit Link Shaman.
We need two shamans, two Shadow Priests. We got their Dispel and our Links.
I keep getting Ravenous Feasted as soon as I hit the Spirit Shell. We're basically R3 healing. Like,
yeah. I don't know. It didn't feel too bad. I really think we need to try and really edge and five, not use that Link four, on that second three, set of Hard Runs.
One.
I can do that. It just...
Yeah, let's edge it.
Crazy.
So, I mean, we'll get close to popping, but that's the idea, right? We're on Goliath.
I think you're so funny, Lex.
I thought it was funny.
Wicked, sorry. And we get an MD out here. Oh, we have the Goliath dead. That's cracked. That's what we want. Bring that noise every pull. Wickeds.
Gotta mail it back up.
Skirmishers are up. Wicked play. It's gonna be Harren first. Get ready to MD. Yeah.
MD.
You think he was wicked blading? Yeah. Soak. Yeah. If we don't get that MD off instantly, we're so fucked.
Do you think a Link would have saved us there?
Just slide off. Probably.
I feel really edged right there.
Yeah. So, I mean, I guess if we don't get that MD off before the crystallize, then it's probably worth it to Spirit Link.
I panicked. I'll be better, because if that event happens, I need to realize I could just blink out of the group instead of running away. So I have the stupid soul shape now.
Right. Right on. It's all good, man.
Yeah, the MD is just super high prio. It, like, it basically scuffs the pull if we don't get it.
I think Wayo killed.
What?
Splintered Heart of Alar.
Wow.
8,000 damage.
That's really bad mannered.
I mean, technically, every time Heart of Alar kills you, the healer's killed you.
Wow.
You keep it a kill counter on that thing?
It's like 9 so far. I racked him up on Zymos because we're all clustered in that fucking corner.
It killed me earlier today.
So if you kill someone with Heart of Alar, does it give you like the
item bags crates? Full of materials?
Yeah.
Oh, it 100% does.
Okay, that's worth.
Technically, you guys are eating yourself in these feasts right now.
Wow,
that's so metal.
Soylent Raid.
I'm not eating myself because you can't kill me with Heart of Alar.
The first thing I did when I got Heart of Alar is I would take crazy fall damage, and then I would use the in Orgrimmar, I'd run into the auction house and fly up, or like I'd fly up really high, drop down and get myself down to 10% health, run into the auction house in Orgrimmar, and then hit the toy Tossel Wrench's mega accurate simulation viewfinder. Basically, like Deathwing just comes and kills you to proc the trinket, and it would just kill like so many level 1 bank alts. It was so funny. Incredibly epic. We need int, and then we're good.
We're close to seeing the next phase. Just need to push past this slight wall.
We've got the deeps. I've seen it.
Tannenbaum, you good? Everyone's ready. Okay.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Skirmies. Good blades. And we get in to soak. Nice.
Watch your spacing for Wicked Blade back up from us.
Heart Rend is coming soon. 10 seconds. Ren's coming in too. No, that's slightly scuffed because, well, we want a big dick the Goliath here. Continue, yeah. Good shit. That's actually really, really good for us. Make sure we're getting in this. Fuck. That one skirmisher is just legit in Narnia. Okay, we recovered.
Careful, watch what we can play. He's close for the wall.
Watch positioning.
Watch for sauce. Watch for sauce.
Going to triangle right after
Rock
this.
Goliath. We MD here, and we Spirit Link.
Get this single taunt's commando.
Sauce, watch out for sauce. Pop CDs now, probably. I know it's only two commandos, but get that out. And then we grip Nimios back in. We sack Wayo. Yeah. Fuck me.
This one.
Big. What I call these cooldowns were 2 minutes even back up.
Yeah, they were.
Yeah.
Okay.
See, my only thought there, Lex, is like the 2 minutes if we start them rolling on the first one, we might not be able to cover the whole thing. So I don't know. Like, shields themselves are pretty squish, though.
I mean, if we get those three adds down, the first three down, we can single target down the other two, no problem.
Right.
Close.
I'm not having memory issues, right? The getting into intermission was pretty damn clean that time.
Yeah, that was nice. Our DPS on the second Goliath was really high. We basically had it dead as the Heartrend debuffs went out, which is essentially what we
less
want,
stressful.
Yeah. I think Max, they actually delay the MD, but they do it till after the Christmas. I don't know. I like our strat right now. With using it ASAP. Feast, I think. Did I drop one?
No, no. You didn't.
Yeah.
Vultures.
Yeah, so they mass the spell after. But they also have all the skirmishers dead, which is a key part of being able to do that.
Slamson, Sam, and Pillow, you guys ready?
Yeah.
Yep.
Got that sweet feast. I'm full.
Yeah, maybe we try that. I don't know.
Try what?
I'm down for change.
Just up. An adjustment on
Five,
spells.
Four,
but...
three, two.
That's what we were doing initially.
One.
Yeah, and it fucking sucked. Because we like couldn't get our cooldowns popped at the right time, and the Goliath kept going into four stacks. So the key part of why that works for them is because the Goliath is dead. So like there's substantial differences in why that works for them versus why it doesn't work for us, right?
Sure.
such a bad spirit link. I'm so sorry. Holy fuck, that's bad play by me. I feel offended that I died. Get her up.
Melee back up.
Oh yeah. Tenenbaum got me.
Poor Caleb.
Back to fucking disgusting shaman play by me.
We can forgive you.
Ron Goliath.
Nice wild spirit.
Yeah, that's beauty.
Heartrend is in three. We have people not taking damage on that somehow. I don't know.
Melee back up to cheat the Wicked Blades on this. Moving a triangle after this blade finishes. Don't cleave it.
Watch
please.
Out for sauce. Watch out for sauce. MD these once we're out of that sauce. And then we link. Get out that. We're gonna be gripping Nemios in. Grip. Good job.
Wicked blades.
Shells.
Nice. We can sack Wayo here if needed. Or try to. We got through it. We're good.
Shell.
Good shit. Artorias dunk.
Slaps and dump.
Oh, it killed me.
Yeah.
Shell.
Oh, Wayo's going
down. It expired. Slaps him.
Oh, shit.
Dispelling revenge.
Sparky dunk. You're gonna die, yeah.
Does it do damage when you dunk it?
Yes, it does.
Alright, that explains why I died.
And it knocks you back. Salmon dunk. Do we soak that crystallize and just say fuck it to try to help keep our tank alive?
I took almost zero damage from the fourth stack. That was not what killed me.
I think it would depend on how Wayo feels, and if he's comfortable, I'd say rip it instead.
I'm fine not soaking it.
Okay.
It wasn't the bleed stacks that killed me.
Okay, if we're gonna not soak it, Lai, you'll be ripping the second person in.
Yeah.
I need to make sure like that the countdown gets all the way and Aikman did it right for me. So never mind.
So
you know
we lost one person to dunking. I think we lost a few people to sauce boss. It's really important to try to avoid the sauce in that phase.
You also take ticking damage when you have the orb.
Yeah, nice. Yeah.
Yeah, a lot of it.
I apologize. I was really tunneling on things that weren't the. Does someone feel confident in calling out the dunks?
I used to work at a dunks.
If you can dodge a wrench, you can dodge a ball. Is it a ball?
Okay, so I'll still just maintain trying to call that out, but that was better.
So for that,
you can't call everything. Like...
For that fourth set of. Art runs, are we doing the individually dispel and announce it plan?
Yeah, and have people pop personals, hellstones kind of thing. Yes. Okay.
Then let's do this. What did we do yesterday? Like Artorias and probably Pillow are the two dispellers.
Make sure that we don't overflow it. Vocal to who we're dispelling, I think it's fine. But
I just don't want all four to go off at the same time without other stuff going up. And since you've got a lot of other stuff on your plate during that round anyway, if we just leave it to the two of them, to call out.
That's fine. Sure. We'll have Artorias and Pillar to Dispels on the fourth one.
Works for me.
Make sure you're paying attention to whether or not you have Heartrend in that in the intermission phase on the fourth set. Trying to pop a personal if you have it up. Wicked Blades. Oof, we splashed. Should be recoverable with this Crystallize if we do it well. Not gonna get in it though, so I'm popping Link early. Good recovery.
Melee, watch your positioning here, back up.
Lion. Heartrend is in six. Heartrend is now. Blades get out. And we're in this Crystallize. Okay, yeah, we're fucking dead. Yeah, so with the Goliath DPS now, with having four healers, it's pretty substantially different.
Got it again, Splintered Heart of War.
Yep, just jump off. Let's try holding those dispels till after the Crystallize. Or, well, like, yeah, like right after the Crystallize. So we'll have cooldowns up for the Crystallize and then.
Yeah, we can. You can Master Spell just before it, too.
Yeah.
Just holding. It'd be the same timing as we do for the first one, where you basically cast it in the middle of the Crystallize cast time.
It's fine to have it go off after, honestly.
Yeah.
Fight's just fucking.
What's the duration on anti-magic?
Duration on what? You cut
15.2
out?
Seconds.
Okay.
Hell yeah.
Weird number.
Yeah, let's try saving FT for after that. That second, because our the timing on the Goliath is just fucked now. So like sometimes we're killing the Goliath before that Heartrend, and sometimes we're not, and it's like we need consistency around that to be able to plan for dispels. If the Goliath is dead, like it's totally fine, but I think the Goliath will be dead before the Crystallize, which gives us a little bit of a buffer and is good. So I like that strategy more. Everyone's ready.
Five, four, three, two, one.
Kids. blades. Get out. Skirmy's coming up.
That's some pulling, right?
What?
Yeah,
hold on this. Yeah. Blades, get out. This is Sparky's totem. Crystallize, we have barrier down. And AMC. Then we MD now. And try to hit. I'm still in the cooldowns. Yeah.
Gonna go to triangle now.
Watch the spaghetti sauce.
Yep. Spaghetti. Then this is WMD again, and pillow hits.
Sauce
spaghetti. We need that MD, boys.
Yep. Shield.
Look at blades, get out.
Second shield.
Shield, shield.
Unfortunate. It was looking pretty decent up till that. It's really close. We're right on the cusp. Alright. Right on the cusp of greatness. Yeah. Definitely a good cusp happening now. Did I already check already? I don't think I did. We need int. Please.
Metrium, grab a food buff. Yeah.
Said it.
Five, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Right on the cusp, boys. We're making prog. Let's keep building. Like Bob would say, yes, we can. Wickets. None of you are Bob Builder fans. Well, just rethink.
I think that phrase has just been tarnished a little bit.
Everything.
Lately.
Everything about your lives. I'm so. sorry, I'm terrible. I got myself. We're good. I just gotta get Uber. Wicked Blades.
Back up in there.
Don't be afraid to call for innervates if you need them as well, Prog. I'm pretty set on mana for this fight.
Me too.
I've got a champ, pretty good groove. Can we innervate Prog? Sorry, I talked over him. We're holding here, Lai. Crystallize, clear your bleeds. Soaks. Can we MD now while we're in the cooldowns? Sweet.
Going to triangle after this next Wicked Blade. He's kind of close to the wall, melee back up.
Watch out for the sauce.
Damn, that's a weird ass timing.
Watch out for that angle on Wicked Blades, yeah. Someone ran to triangle or diamond with it.
That was me. Oh, I mean, I heroically used to triangle. I don't think it was me, actually.
The raid literally got nuked back before you heroically leaped. Let's try to keep going. We would MD.
We MD.
Oh, never mind. I think our priest that normally does the MB there is dead, so.
Correct.
Okay.
Yeah.
What's the reasoning behind bringing Kale to triangle for intermission?
Because if you tank it anywhere else, you get knocked back.
Yeah.
You just don't want Kale on the raid.
Who gets knocked back, and by what?
Whoever.
Tank.
Well, the tank and whoever has the Wicked Blades.
Yes.
Gotcha.
Because we have to deliver the mana.
Mm-hmm. All right, quick, we got time for an all-nighter.
Yeah, let's do
hell
one more.
Yeah.
We'll do one more.
For that last Wicked Blade, did the people who had the Wicked Blade do the right thing? Or
I think we have time to move Cal before
that
Wicked
so
Blade.
Too.
Like, yeah. I don't know why we're staying at Nipple or Star.
The timing can get really weird. Like, I've tried to move him right after the crystallize and a Wicked Blade comes out immediately and it's just shit.
As soon as Call hits 50%,
you can move
him. Moved.
Like,
yeah.
DPS doesn't matter on Call because he takes reduced damage anyways.
Oh yeah, and like, I'm not worried about DPS, I'm worried about if I move him early and Wicked Blade fucks people up.
No, I think you move him every time there.
It's probably better to have him away from the wall than have him like right next to where all the raid is going to be, because if he does the Wicked Blades and we have to dodge the fucking red shit on the ground and people
sauce.
Are
yeah, yeah,
yeah, the sauce, yeah, yeah.
Like when I had call on Sunday, I always moved them at 50% and I don't think the Wicked Blades ever went into the raid.
I also feel like everyone can just assume that call is going to be by triangle position the Wicked Blades accordingly.
Yeah, all right, let's get one quick one more. Yeah, I think we're being a little just too conservative with moving call there. So that's my hot take.
This sounds like
as the kids are calling it.
Would call me too conservative.
Hell yeah. Everyone's ready. Do we want to just hero on those shells to get past that hump? I think we do.
Yeah.
I don't know. I like it. Let's just hero on the fucking commandos.
One.
He's in a little close.
We're okay. Wicked Blades are in Fiver. We're on Goliath. Can't totem, sorry.
I'll save you.
I'm stunned. Yeah. Thanks, Step Bro.
Melee back it up.
We're on Goliath.
Innervate proc champ.
Holy fuck, man.
I'll save you.
Getting so hate crimed here. Wicked Blades. Crystallize, we get in. And we MD in the cooldowns. Ignore boss. We pop cooldowns to live.
I think we want to try to make that MD something that gets cast before the crystallize hits, because my barrier doesn't last through the end of heart rend. Only 10 seconds duration.
Fair.
By the way, guys, you can sit on the ledge here.
Yeah, true. We can MD this.
Coming.
And we link. Good shit. Watch out for sauce. Watch out for sauce. We can get him up. Sauce. Sauce. Shells. And blades. Nice job. Spartana dunk. Spark dunk.
Do I grip him or is this you?
Warlock, you take the warlock.
Yeah. Yeah, you get the next one.
Leon Cull dunk. Take the warlock portal if you have to. Egg, you have to dunk. ASAP.
Do.
Arky dunk again.
Spelling free link.
I'm dispelling myself.
Can I get a pain sap on the next? I'll call for it.
I'll break the shell. Artorias has to dunk.
Okay.
We did not break the shell. That's okay. You know, we almost got to Prince Renathal's favorite phase, which is making it through the intermission phase.
So is there a point where we stopped killing commanders?
We needed to kill two more there. We had two homies ready to dunk. We would have needed two more dead. But yeah.
So Wayo doesn't die there anymore. So I don't think I need to use APT.
I think it's still beneficial to run it, but it's better than...
Here's the thing, you're gonna need it anyways, because I had no gas, no cooldown gas left in the tank, and I was gonna get at least one more stack, which would have for sure killed me. Like, my trinket is the only thing that kept me alive. It procced, like the save death trinket procced on the fifth stack, so.
We made some prog there towards the end, that was nice. I don't know why, with four healers, we're still struggling so much on the shields, but could just be people kind of like overestimating how much they need to move or how much they need to compensate for a mechanic. I don't know.
You might also just need to...
A lot of pops on the ground sometime.
I think people just need to hard swap to the shell.
Well, I think we need to set a person to start marking targets as skulls so that everyone who's like cleaving off of an ad does it from the same ad.
That definitely could be, you know, an idea for sure. That's a bit above my personal pay grade, but...
I mean, just to add to a DPS and have them not throw it into their auto attacks.
Or would it be beneficial to just pop cooldowns after getting two commandos, since we'll pretty much just blast them immediately, and then as we get the third and fourth, we'll also be blasting since...
That's a lot of blasting going on.
The duration should still persist through... some way or somewhat through the third commando at least, and the fourth is like pretty easy to do since it's the only commando left.
If we're looking for like a focus to follow for that, I mean, setting an assist target would probably be the easiest way, because I've had to use that before for certain raid fights, and just pick the one person you know isn't gonna fuck it up.
I think at the very least it's good to have at least a visual on who we're supposed to be targeting, so just like put a skull on whoever the main focus.
Well, that's
is.
Why you just set him as an assist target.
Yeah, and then he has to
not
make it so
mark
that's...
on him. But so you actually like just like in a tank frame, you see the tank's target, you'll see their target.
That's not as easy in my
that, opinion. I don't think that works because the tank won't always be targeting.
Well, that's why
the
I'm saying
priority target.
Yeah, no, I'm not saying use the tank as the focus target. For assist.
You're saying make a...
Okay, to give you an example. Okay, I used a mage on Hive Mind to make sure they were always on the thing that needed to die, so all the DPS knew that's the thing you blow up. It's just like setting a main tank, you just set a DPS player as it.
Again, whoever's doing that just needs to set a macro on one of the main abilities.
To make the skull marker, yeah.
Like, it's trivial to do that, you can do both.
Yeah.
Yeah, because I mean, some people aren't going to be registering a mark, others are going to be, and it's going to go both ways.
So, like, I'm definitely not going to register what the focus target is targeting.
I always look at targets. So I'm not gonna register a mark necessarily before I'd be like, oh, that's my focus target person. Cool.
Yeah, the focus target is.
It's also fairly intuitive with the fact that they get a giant shield and start casting.
Yeah, I'm not finding it hard to find the ones because I mean I'm also running the weak aura for all the adds with their health.
Well, I think the problem
might just be cooldown timing, and who knows.
But I'm gonna look after I gotta take my dog out, but I'm gonna look some stuff up, and if it shows the breakdown that I'm thinking it'll show, Lex, I'll send it to you.
I don't know, it doesn't kill you. I think the problem with just saying focus the one when the shield comes up is that we're getting like three of them with the shields coming at the same time, or around the same time. So people aren't able to swap properly. And then shields are overlapping. Because we're
that only works when people have cooldowns up, like.
It's like a three could fill in like 30%, while another one got like 70%, then that's super easy. But if you get them to like 30% at the same time, that's not easy.
Yeah.
Yeah. All in all, it was a good night. Everybody did really well.
Yeah, good job.
Heck yeah. Did you see us?
Yeah. I watched a bit.
Yeah, we kind of came out like how Stone Cold Steve Austin used to do back in his day, and handed out, you know, an ass whooping.
All right, well, we're still kind of in the same position for SLG. Probably be another maybe 30, 40 pulls before we get to actual phase two with Grishol. Maybe. We'll see. Thanks for watching.